So we have today Sam Henderson, two times regional athlete and head coach of tailor-made programming. For today we're going to be talking about the Open for 2019. We're going to hit into some tips for how to approach the Open this year. So first, we're going to talk about the warm-up. Any specific advice for people how to warm up?
Yes, absolutely. So obviously normally if you're in a class scenario or if you're doing your own training, you typically do your Metcon at the end of a session. So you'll finish, say, your lifting piece or your gymnastic piece, you'll do a short warm-up, and then you'll go into your Metcon. Okay, obviously for the Open workouts, you want to be fresh going into those workouts, so you're not going to already have done training prior to hitting the workout. So it's important that you have your thought through a good warm-up specific to that workout, so that when you come into the gym, you know what you're doing. Okay, a lot of it comes down to knowing you, obviously knowing the workout, and then deciding on a workout specific warm-up. So for example, if we have a workout where there's things like handstand push-ups or thrusters, making sure you want to start off by mobilizing that overhead position. Okay, making sure that your lockout is going to be good. Obviously when you've been judged, you don't want to have any no reps for not locking out, especially when it comes to that handstand push-up standing that can be a little bit awkward. Okay, so a good Open warm-up will start off with some kind of mobility work. Okay, and then from there we might have some kind of activation work or balance work, kind of looking at maybe single leg deadlifts if it's a deadlift workout, make sure both sides are working evenly, single arm overhead pressing, things like that, which is not going to be taxing, but it's just going to prepare your body for what's coming. Okay, from there obviously we want to look at the actual movements that are in the workout. So if there's, say, heavy snatches in there, you're going to build up to the working weight for your snatches or cleans or whichever movement it is. If it's any of the more technical movements, so your muscle-ups, your handstand push-ups, you might spend a bit more time warming those up and getting comfortable with the technique. Okay, from there, obviously, Open workouts tend to be done at the highest possible intensity. Okay, so what we don't want to do is go into the workout from a standing start, straight into a workout where we're going to be working at high intensity. It's going to get your heart rate really quick, and that initial rise in heart rate can take you by surprise a little bit and put you off for the rest of the workout. So it's important before you start the workout, you've elevated your heart rate. Okay, so that might look like doing a couple of short practice rounds of the workout, yeah, depending on what it is. It might be using the assault bike, maybe mixing that in with some of the movements that are in the workout, not so that you're already pre-fatigued, just so that your heart rate's elevated and your body's switched on, ready to go, ready for what's about to hit it.
One of the things that I like to do, if there's, for example, the thrusters, let's say, are at 95 pounds, I like to build up the weight into a slightly heavier weight. So when you take that weight off, suddenly it feels lighter and you can move faster, kind of a, like a mental trick.
Yeah.
I like doing this. I don't know if you agree with that.
Yeah, if it works for you.
But it should be also not taxing, of course.
Yeah.
The next part, setting a strategy for your Open game. So how to approach each workout, how to set a successful strategy.
So obviously each workout is going to require a different strategy, and each person is going to require a slightly different strategy for each workout. Yeah, depending on the movements that are involved. If it's gymnastic movements, for example, we don't want to set a strategy that's going to see us burn out in the first 2 minutes. Okay, so that's where it's important that you know yourself and you know what you're capable of. So that if you have a workout which starts off with, say for example, 50 chest bar pull-ups, and you know that your max chest bar is around 20 reps, you don't want to start off with a max effort set of 20, because it's going to make the next 30 much more difficult. Okay, so it's about knowing your limit and working at a percentage of that limit so that you can maintain a good pace throughout the workout. Okay, similarly, when there's, say, heavy barbells involved, we want to make sure that you don't set off too hard or you elevate your heart rate too high, but when it comes to a heavy lift, you end up having to break a lot more than you would if you'd have paced it slightly earlier on in the workout. Okay, so there's that aspect to it. There's also the aspect of knowing how many rounds you're going to be aiming for and devising a strategy that's going to help you there. Okay, if it's a long workout or even if it's a short workout, and knowing what you're aiming for can mean that you can think about how long you think each movement is going to take you, where you think you might need to rest, plan how you're going to reach your target number of rounds. Okay, obviously the open workout is different to just doing your normal workout in the gym, where in the gym you might be able to go all out, and if you burn out, you burn out. Okay, but in the open, we're looking at getting the best possible score. So your strategy needs to take your strengths and weaknesses into account, the workout into account, and to between the two, find the way to get the best possible score for you.
So take whatever is your strength and use it to your advantage. Whatever is your weakness movement, try to break it more often or set it into a different system you would usually do, just to make sure that you're going to be sustaining your energy levels throughout the workout. So. Last topic we're going to be talking about, which is the most important one, I think, it's the one I need to work on, it's the mental approach for each workout.
Yeah.
So any specific tips, especially that you have completed already, you know how what it takes?
Yeah, definitely. So I think, obviously, the mental approach, again, it depends on the workout. Okay, if we go back to, say, the thrusters and burpee example, then the mental approach on a workout like that needs to be that you're willing to go through some pain. Okay? It doesn't matter how you pace it, a workout like that is going to hurt. So in my opinion, you might as well push it as hard as you can and get it done as soon as possible. Okay? As quick as possible, a lot of the time. What you might see on a workout like that is, say people get to the burpees and they slow down a little bit, or they have like a 5-10 second break before the thrusters, and all these 5-10 seconds add up and they can add a sort of 30 seconds to a minute onto your time. Okay, so on a workout like that one, you need to be willing to suffer, minimize your breaks, minimize your transition time. Okay, and it's a hard thing to do, but you just need to remember it's going to be for say 10 minutes and then it's done. Okay, and a lot of the times workouts like that, that's what separates good scores from really good scores, is how willing people are to hurt a little bit or a lot. Okay, the other aspect of that is when you get a workout which is higher skill or a heavier lift, and that could be heavier relative to you or just heavier in general, that's when you need to take a slightly different mental approach. Okay, obviously, like I said before, if you go all out from the start on a workout like that, by the time you get to the high skill or heavy barbell, then it's going to make life much more difficult for you. So on a workout like that, it's much more about thinking about how you're going to be consistent all the way through. So mentally, that means that you need to try and calm down a little bit. Okay, obviously the first round of an open workout, there's a lot of adrenaline, you want to go all out, but if you know what's coming, then mentally you need to be able to just control your own tempo, not worry about what anyone else is doing around you, and remember what you need to do.
How do you usually fight the bad thoughts inside your head, like, why am I doing this? Let's stop, yeah. Let's break the set. How do you deal with these type of thoughts inside your head?
Well, I think they're thoughts which everybody gets, but I think what you have to think about is those thoughts only really ever appear in the first round or the first couple of minutes of that workout when it first starts to hurt.
Really?
Okay, once you've got through the first couple of rounds, or especially past that halfway mark, well, you're invested in the workout then, you're already exhausted, so you might as well keep pushing. There's nothing to be gained by backing off just because it feels uncomfortable. Okay, I remember obviously the open workouts are looking to find the fittest people in the world, so they're going to be uncomfortable.
These were the three major tips, how to set a successful warm-up, strategy and mental approach for the open. Thank you for this video.